All right, guys, here we are again. It seemed like people liked the last ISS Enduro race that we filmed, so we decided we'd come do another one. We are here in Wausau for the first time ever. The Impact Survival Series is going to see over 100 cars. This is actually 120 cars. Their previous record was 98. We are putting 120 cars on the track at one time for 300 laps. Not a whole lot of room on this track. Not much for places to go. Should be fun to watch. Appreciate you guys following along. We're going to try the first ever rolling start in the ISS series.
Tough to tighten up a field of 25.
I don't know how it's going to work.
This size, imagine 120. Well, you don't have to imagine. They're here. You're here. Who's ready to go racing, folks?
Flag on your signal.
get that driver extricated from that car quickly. Safety crews will go on the scene to check it out.
Oh, he's upside down.
Wow, that's tough stuff, folks. Frank Calabrese, a multi-time champion in this series, a champion in the Midwest Enduro Series. He's been in this for a long, long time. Safety crew on the way out there.
I had no idea what happened.
I didn't see it.
Tell you what, folks, some of these cars might look a little rough to you, but on the inside, they are built tough. We've got a lot of safety factors built into these cars. Full roll cages in many of the cars out there, almost all of them that I know of. Official word, but I just did hear on one of the safety radios they're going to put that car back on its wheels, and that means the driver's got to be okay, otherwise they'd extricate him first. That's a good thing.
He's still strapped in. He said, don't undo me. I'm not getting out of here.
Happy to see you all right, Frank. I hope they get enough guys over there to help push you back over.
It should be a pretty light car.
Oh, yeah. Folks, you don't get much more of a classy guy than that guy right there that unfortunately is upside down.
He's been doing it a long time.
Been with this series since it started. Oh, now he's out.
Well, in the meantime, the 98 car of Matt McCathron is smoking badly. Looks like he may try to make his way off to the pits and effect repairs. Now, if a car does have to move under red, they're allowed to move off to the pits. They will get a one-lap penalty. There's Frank Calabrese out of the car on the backstretch. Still has the helmet on. He's checking things out. Knowing Frank, there he goes. He's getting back in the car. And he's going to strap in and go for it again, folks. Look at that.
Nice job, Frank. That's the way it should be.
One of the nicest guys in our series, and they don't make them any tougher than Flying Frank.
All right, folks, we'll catch you back on the green flag.
More time, folks. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
don't even get a number on that vehicle.
Oh.
Ten laps in right now.
87
that
you normally
has. That was a lot of smoke coming out of what appears to be the 48H car on the back stretch. 3, 2, 1. Thank you. as well. His day may be over too. Looking at the 112 car out there on the backstretch, Max Summers. Boy, he's got some. 3, 2, 1. Just a minute. Hey, how about that? 25. 25% off all select items at the State Park Speedway store right now. You might want to check that out. T-shirts, sweatshirts, hoodies, hats, all kinds of State Park Speedway swag. 25% off today here at the track. That's right by the grandstand. You'll want to check it out. A little bit of a cloud coming up in turn four. Don't know where that smoke's coming from, but smoke, never a good sign on the racetrack. Hopefully everybody gets restarted when the green flag flies. We'll find out in just a moment. Safety crew back in position, waiting for the signal from the starter stand. There it is, let's count them down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Safety hazard. So off he'll go to the pits. Well, look at that. The 13 car of Jake Falk was also stalled out at the top of turn one. He's now walking into the infield with safety people. And unfortunately, he will be done for now. They get the opportunity to try and restart those cars at the halfway point, folks. If they can restart them, they can move them.
Look at the smoke coming out of them right now.
Wow, a lot of smoke coming out of the 33 and a third Lashua here on the front stretch. That could be a problem. Might want to take that one off to the fence and get it checked out. As we wait for the safety crews, checking on a couple of the drivers out there. Three, two, one. All right, the number 926 car. Matt's door up in turn three. Apparently the car is disabled.
And there, folks, is somebody getting out of my old car.
Once again, we've got cars.
Hope it's okay.
The red flag.
Kind of like that car.
Not a big problem or anything like that, but if a car's breaking down on the track, the drivers can elect to take that one lap penalty for moving under the red, go off the pits, get the car repaired, rather than break the thing totally and end up not finishing the race. All right, so the drivers out of the 926 car, that'll be left up on the back stretch. Not a big deal, he got it off into the grass. Smooth move, in my opinion. Way to go, Matt Thorne. Leave that track wide open for the other drivers and keep your car in one piece, right? And we're just waiting for the signal to restart the race. Safety workers are in position. There's the signal. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Three, two, one.
been hit real hard twice.
There's a whole pile of rust right underneath it.
Whoa, Troy Tomb of the 201 car. He had been running in the top 10. Gonna check his position. He was third in the race, folks, and he just went into the pits. That's gonna drop him one lap, and he will drop out of the top 10. I'm almost sure.
Hi, Josh.
We'll keep our eyes open as the race continues, and we'll check the top 10 after the race restarts. But I guess if you're gonna have something break, now's the time. You can fix it before the break. Maybe come out strong in the second half and get a better position. Tell you what, folks, anybody that finished top five today, it's an accomplishment to finish one of these races in the first place. But with 120 cars to finish in the top five, that's a major achievement. They're gonna get major money for finishing in the top five today as well. And I can see Tuma's car is already in line back on the track. He may not drop out of the top 10 if that's the case. Signal from the safety crew and the starter.
What did he say was wrong with that one?
He's on fire.
Oh, that's what I thought. He'll be all right.
And there it is. We're ready to go. We'll count them down from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Guys, we're gonna let them get this cleaned up. I think it'll be a while. We'll get back with you here soon.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
little smoke out every time. That's the one over the transmission in last year.
Well, checking up in the 11 through 20 positions, Brian Adams up to the 15th spot, Josh Kopotic up to 13th.
Nice.
Nice job,
Dave. Dave Moore still on the outside looking in at 21st. Scott Fetters dropped all the way out of the top spot down to 22nd. Dale Shatek, 23rd. Eddie Munster in the 25th spot, usually a hard runner, but no hard luck today, I guess.
What was wrong with it up there?
She didn't like it up there.
Oh, did you? Do you like it better up there?
And another car moving under the bridge. Triple H car, DJ Everhart. More problems for him today. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Easy, easy.
Yep, we've got a disabled tire over at 34. Window net is down. That's a good sign. And safety crew over there to take care of them. Well, we got a minute, folks. That guy out there on the safety crew over in turn four helping out that disabled driver. That's Jimbo Slice. He's been with us for a long, long time as a corner worker. Thanks for your service, Jimbo. This will be his last race with the Impact Survival Series. Thank you very much. And, oh, want to say happy birthday to the driver of the 18F car, Dylan Fromm. Happy birthday. Well, we're going to clear that driver. We've got some other cars, that 12.1 car smoking big time, hoping to keep that car together until at least 150. Save the motor. All right, waiting for the signal. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
debris, that wheel off of the one car up in 3, 2, 1.
It's just out of oil.
Yeah.
Well, guys, we're going to call that one half one. We're going to call this a video. Hope you guys have liked it so far. It's definitely been crazy. We're going to see plenty more to come. I'll get some of the driver interviews on the start of the next session. That'll be the start of the second half of the ISS race. Thanks for following along. And as always,
get goose!